Welcome back to your weekly GIDDYUP.
This past Wednesday at our senior town hall, we had our little graduation rundown. Lots of information that you're going to need if you want to
attend graduation, you know?
Graduate, yeah, if you want to be there. If you want to graduate, like, at all.
That's true.
That is important. Pass those classes.
Speaking of seniors,
yeah,
we're coming up on Senior Sunset. That'll be real soon. So, if you're interested in planning for Senior Sunset, then meet in Miss Morrison's room on Tuesdays. Until then, keep you updated. But for now, make sure you're attending those meetings if you're interested on planning that Senior Sunset. Canned Food Drive!
Spanish Club is having a canned food drive. Donate your canned foods, the good kind, nothing like expired or opened or
non-perishable.
Make it non-perishable. So like nothing that's expired, damaged, eaten. I wouldn't want eaten food. Yeah. So, if you got those cans, bring them to Mr. Real's room or Miss Arrowwood's room.
Located in IA.
And A Hall.
IA Hall.
IA Hall?
Yeah.
You know where those rooms are. If you don't, ask around. Talk to someone new. Make a new friend.
You
should always make new friends. Yeah. This past Wednesday, we had our annual freshman night here at Wooster. We had a lot of information for these incoming students. It was a great hit. We have some footage that's playing right now. And good luck to all those freshmen. Don't think they're seeing this because they're still
freshmen
in middle school. Yeah. All those incoming freshmen. Hope to see you next year. We won't see you next year. I hope I don't see you next year.
Cross our fingers for Trevor.
Yeah. I want to graduate. But yeah, maybe I'll see you on the streets. Say hi.
This past week, we also had our blood drive here at Wooster. It's a great thing. Remember, if you can donate blood, you can save up to 3 lives. So it's a great thing to do if you are turning 16 soon or are 16 and older. Make sure you sign up to donate so that next year you'll be able to. I'm a universal donor, dude. I can save any kind of life.
I'm more of a Disney donor. It's better than universal.
All right, if you are watching this on Thursday or Friday, you still have a chance to watch Fox on the Fairway at 7 o'clock. Saturday, tomorrow, is also 7 o'clock. And if you are willing to watch on Sunday, then we have a show at 2 o'clock for you. So make sure you support the Wooster Players and their production of the Fox on the Fairway. I'm sure it'll be a great show. I'll see you guys there.
Let's take it over to Bryson Parco.
He's got some good highlights for these upcoming
fall sports.
Bryson Parco, and here's your sports report. For the next few weeks, we're going to start talking about fall sports that have summer and spring programs. This week, we have football. Starting July, there's summer weights and a 1-week football camp. As soon as school starts next year, practice will begin. If you have any questions, make sure to contact Coach Sellers. That's been today's sports report. Back to you, Eddie and Trevor.
Great job to Bryson and his sports report team. They always do a fine job.
Let's take it over to our club announcements team with our disc golf.
Disc golf.
Disc golf team.
Disc golf. Not disc golf.
Disc golf. Call.
Dude, imagine like a golf where like you diss people.
That'd be really
yeah.
Positive energy.
Disc golf, not disc golf.
Don't disc.
Do not diss people.
Roll that footage.
Hey guys, I'm Mia and this is the Club Announces. Today we have Steven and Tylee from Disc Golf. Today they'll be talking about all the things you do in disc golf and how to join it. Let's take it over to them.
Hi, I'm Steven.
I'm Tylee.
We're both presidents of the Disc Golf Club. Basically, what disc golf is, it's like golf, but with frisbees, and you try to get it in the basket. If you want to join, you can come to B2, which is also Vaughn's room, every Monday at lunch. And practices, we normally do like every Saturday or Sunday, or wherever on break. And we meet at Rancho, or there's a couple other courses.
Okay, guys, that's all the club announcements we have today. Back to you, Eddie and Trevor.
Thanks for that look at disc golf.
You did it again.
Licky disc golf. Thanks for that look at the new disc golf club. There. Colt highlight on ROTC, the ROTC battalion. Colt battalion.
ROTC is important to me because as a freshman, I was really nervous and really shy, and to an extent, I still am, but it's helped me come out of my shell a lot. I've met a lot of great people. I've met some of my best friends through ROTC, and it's something that's really helped me be more comfortable around people and meeting people and willing to become friends with new people.
Personally, to me, it's a class that teaches you basic disciplinary skills and other important things that you wouldn't normally receive in your other classes that are potentially you could use outside of school.
ROTC stands for Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps. It is a program at many different high schools where they teach you the bare minimum of what it takes to become a leader through different lessons about leadership as well as other lessons about finance and social skills.
A lot of the cool things that we've done in ROTC are events like the Cadet Olympics or the drill meets. And basically what it is you learn routines with you and your teammates and you guys compete to see who has the best drill team. And we did win first place a couple times, which was very fun. And stuff like Cadet Olympics, which is a physical event, which includes stuff like pull-ups, push-ups, really fun stuff if you're into that. It's really fun to meet with your other schools in the district and compete against them, have fun. I've met a lot of great friends at other schools through these drill meets, and it's really cool, really fun stuff. And also we do a lot of volunteer work, like the Italian Festival. We partner up with Spanish Club with that. It's really fun. And there's just a plethora of things that we do through ROTC that allow us to work with other clubs in the school and the entire community as a whole. So today is Friday. That means yesterday was the release of the biggest movie of the year, Avengers Endgame.
The Rise of Skywalker has yet to come out. That will be the biggest movie of the year.
Will it?
Yes.
Will it?
No. X-Men Dark Phoenix will be the biggest movie of the year.
Okay, alright. Enough jokes.
No jokes. No more jokes. Yeah.
So.
We got to see Avengers Endgame.
We did.
Yeah.
So, we're going to talk about it. We're going to review it real quick. So, what was your favorite part of the movie, Trevor?
Best part was when the portal opened and all these Star Wars characters started coming in. They're blending the two universes. Not only that, the Star Wars took the X-Men with them. Now all these X-Men and Star Wars characters, you know, they were fighting with the Avengers, fighting Thanos. You know, Darth Vader was in there.
I think it was a bold move by Disney to combine all these universes.
Yeah.
However, I would have liked the X-Men to have a better debut. I think they should have debuted with their own movie.
Yeah. And I thought it was surprising that Marvel and DC settled their differences to join the Avengers and the Justice League, into the Avengers League of Justice.
Yeah, I wasn't a big fan of that.
You didn't like that?
No, you see, it's just the way they CGI'd Superman's mustache.
Oh,
it was just,
yeah.
I didn't like it. And I get it, he's in another movie, But he was only in there for like 5 seconds. He couldn't have shaved real quick and then just left.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see the relationship between like Superman and Captain America, because they kind of got the same, like,
yeah,
they got the same shtick.
And I didn't like that they de-aged Captain Marvel to 5 years old. That was kind of,
yeah,
was kind of a little weird.
Yeah, when that scene where they made everyone into babies and they were just baby versions of themselves,
yeah,
fighting Thanos, that was really weird.
Yeah, I felt really bad for Tony Stark, how he turned into a baby, but his suit was the same size, so he was just,
yeah,
getting suffocated.
Yes.
Not,
why would he be suffocated?
It's a big suit.
Yeah.
But he's a baby.
Yes, he has lots of room in there.
Yeah, but the helmet is closed, bro.
Wow.
All right, so in light of this Endgame, Marvel's newest movie, final movie of this saga, what do you
an
think?
Era. End of an era, really.
Well, not really. We have Spider-Man at the end.
Yeah, but it's been like 10 years. I remember seeing the original Iron Man in theaters. That was a good movie. Great movie.
So with 20 plus movies in the book with Marvel, it's pretty obvious which one is the best one, right?
Obviously.
It's obviously Iron Man
3.
Dude, come on.
Thanks for watching this week's Giddy Up and our Marvel recap. We'll see you next week. May all your favorite bands stay together.
Unless you like Spider-Man 3.
It's a good movie.